right, guys, this scene looks like a real movie. But it wasn't filmed, it was built. No actors, no cameras, no crew. Just a few AI tools and one big question. Can we make it feel real? I wanted to prove that you don't need a high budget or a film studio to create cinematic dialogue scenes that hit hard. So I spent weeks testing tools to save you months of trial and error. In this video, I'll show you the full process. From the first line of dialogue to the final lip sync, how to turn simple prompts into a scene that feels alive. And no, you don't need editing experience, just a laptop and a bit of curiosity. Here's a quick sneak peek of what we're building.
Ran. And now someone's dead.
It wasn't supposed to happen like that.
You're not a very good liar, Evelyn.
Oh, and there's a bonus waiting at the end. But not the usual kind. This one's hidden inside the video and only shows up if you stick around till the end. Now it's your turn. Let's turn prompts into pure movie magic. So let's go! All right, open the Google Doc linked in the video description. This is your mission control. You'll find the exact tools and prompts we'll use to build the full dialogue scene. You'll find every tool and every prompt you need to build one thing, a believable, emotionally charged dialogue scene powered entirely by AI. Why this matters? Having the right tools lined up means no interruptions later. You'll move faster and more focused from prompt to final scene. So let's meet your main character. Because a dialogue scene isn't built on prompts alone, it begins with a face, a presence, a spark. Let's build that now and bring our characters to life visually. Copy the first prompt from our Google Doc, highlight it in blue. Paste it into ChatGPT. Now he asks for a suitable character description. Here you fill in your character description or copy my prepared answer from the Google Doc. Paste it into the same ChatGPT chat. ChatGPT now generates MidJourney prompts designed to create consistent character references. Why this matters? In a cinematic dialogue, the face is your actor. Every pause, every glance, every micro expression has to match the words. That's why consistency isn't optional. It's everything. Head over to MidJourney, paste the prompt, and let the images generate. Click rerun a few times. Same prompt, multiple interpretations. Why this matters? Even with the same input, MidJourney offers variety. We're looking for a close-up that feels natural, human, and cinematic. Pro tip from experience. Avoid anything that looks like a game character. Go for something grounded, something that fits your scene. Once you find the right image, click it. Hit upscale subtle. Zoom out using 2x. Upscale again. The result, a high-res image that becomes your main reference. This visual will guide the consistency for the entire dialogue sequence, so take the time to get it right. So let's complete the character foundation. Head back to ChatGPT and grab the next prompt. This one's for profile views. Then go to MidJourney. Click your selected reference image and choose image under use. You'll see the image appear above the prompt bar. Now activate C-Ref, the icon that looks like a person. This tells MidJourney to keep the character consistent. Paste your new prompt into the field. Click rerun a few times. This gives you variations with the same character design. Review the results and upscale the best ones. Create a folder to organize your selected images. These profile shots will help later, especially for shots where angles shift slightly between dialogue lines. That's it. Your character consistency is locked in. And now we're going to turn this character into a real person with voice, emotion, and story. And the next step is where the dialogue begins. Let's break down exactly how I did it and how you can follow the same steps to build your own version. This isn't just a walkthrough. It's a full behind-the-scenes breakdown of how I created this AI-driven dialogue scene and the key lessons I learned along the way. So let's get started. Head over to the Google Doc and copy the second prompt you see marked in yellow. Paste it into a new ChatGPT conversation. Once the prompt is pasted in, ChatGPT gets to work. First, it creates a MidJourney style visual description, something we'll use as a reference image throughout the scene building process. Then it asks a simple question. Do you already have a dialogue in mind? I gave it full creative freedom and typed go for it. That's our launch pad. Now type go for step two. This triggers ChatGPT to create image prompts tailored specifically to the lines of dialogue it just wrote. Let's take the first image prompt and head over to MidJourney. Paste the prompt into the input field. Now click the gear icon in the top right. Set the aspect ratio to 16:9 and change the mode to raw. This unlocks much more realistic results. Now send the prompt and watch what happens. Here's how I usually start. I run the prompt without any reference images. Why? Because I want to see if MidJourney gets the vibe on its own, without being guided. The results were surprisingly decent, but then I spotted a problem, a big one. It showed rain inside the room instead of outside the window where it's supposed to be. That instantly broke the immersion, so I tweaked the wording and ran it again. This time, way better. Now hit rerun a few times to generate additional additional variations. Scroll through them and upscale the ones that feel right for your scene. I picked two that really stood out, and we'll use those as our core visual references moving forward. Now, back to ChatGPT. Copy the first actual dialogue-specific prompt and paste it into MidJourney. The result? Pretty solid again. But the rain was still inside the room, so I jumped back in, modified the wording, and resubmitted. Now we're talking. This version had the rain outside the window, just like we wanted. Let's refine this even more. Click the original prompt to auto-load it back into the field. Then click the reference image, go to Use, and click Style. This tells MidJourney to match the visual tone of your earlier result. Send the prompt. This one didn't quite land, so let's double down. Click the earlier style reference again, it'll auto-load. Now, combine that with a character reference, one of the close-up shots we created earlier using the first master prompt. Send it again, we're getting closer. To expand your creative options, try running the prompt a few different ways. First, with just the character reference, then with all three, character, image, and style references combined. Each combo gives you a slightly different visual result, and honestly, you might be surprised how much the vibe can shift. Mix and match. Experiment. Explore the full potential of MidJourney. If something clicks, hit rerun to get more variations in the same style. Or try very strong. It keeps the core structure but plays with the details. Once you've got a collection of strong images, review them and upscale your favorites. Label your files. Seriously, future will thank you. Repeat this process for every image you want to include in your scene. At this point, you now have a custom written dialogue and a full set of high quality images to match it. So now let's move to the next step, turning your written dialogue into a voice that feels real. For that, I'm using one of the best tools I've tested so far, DupDub. But here's the thing, DupDub isn't just another voiceover generator. It's more like a content assistant for creators, packed with features that actually matter in storytelling. So why did I pick it for this scene? Simple. In cinematic storytelling, we don't just need any voice, we need emotion. We need voices that match the characters, that sound like they belong in the world we've built. DupDub delivers exactly that. You can assign one voice across different emotions, which is absolutely crucial for dialogue-driven storytelling. Let me show you how I did it. Start by heading back to ChatGPT and copy all lines of the dialogue. Now go to DupDub, click AI voiceover on the homepage, then click on multiple voiceovers and paste in the entire dialogue. Remember the emotion of the first line. Click on the profile picture on the left. Now go to multi-emotive. Under quality, select ultra, then choose the appropriate gender. Listen to the available voices and pick one that fits. Now adjust the emotion of the voice on the right side by selecting the correct option under emotion. Once done, confirm everything by clicking select. Next, delete the line where the emotion was originally specified, and move the correct line up. Repeat the same process for the second voice in the dialogue. Always make sure the selected emotion matches the intended one. At the top right, click the play button to preview the entire dialogue.
I didn't pull the trigger, but I saw who did.
You saw? Why the hell didn't you say that earlier?
Once you're happy with it, click on Export at the top and choose Wave. And just like that, you've created realistic, emotionally tuned voiceovers for every character in your scene. That's a huge milestone, but we're not done yet. It's time to animate your dialogue scene and bring those still images to life. Start with the first image from your sequence. Drag it into ChatGPT and enter this prompt. Give me for this photo a bundled prompt for KlingAI to animate this photo to match the dialogue. It is a solo frame, so no start and end frame option. Now replace set one with your actual line of dialogue. This tells ChatGPT exactly what kind of emotion and motion the animation should reflect. It's where stillness starts to move and your characters finally come alive. Once you get your animation prompt from ChatGPT, copy it. Now, head over to KlingAI. Go to the Image to Video tab and upload the image you want to animate. Paste in the prompt you just copied. Now here's an important tweak. At the top, switch from Kling 2.0 to Kling 1.6. Why? Kling 1.6 is cheaper, and for single frame animations like this, it works like a charm. Next, scroll down and set the prompt relevance to 0.65. Now hit generate and let KlingAI do its thing. Wait for the animation to render. If the result looks good, we're ready to bring that voice to life. Click on the animation preview. In the bottom right corner under Next Steps, click Lip Sync. Now drag and drop your voiceover file, the one we created earlier in DupDub, into the Upload Local Dubbing box. Then click Generate. This is the moment it all comes together. DupDub's voice plus KlingAI's animation equals a fully synchronized scene, one that finally brings your character to life. Once it's done, click the animation again. In the top right corner, click Download to save it, and don't forget to label your files. Now repeat the same steps for every image in your dialogue sequence. Each image becomes its own short animation, and each one matches perfectly with a voiceover line. Once you've animated every line, get ready, because we're moving into the fun part, editing it all together in and CapCut. Start by creating a new project. Click the Modify button on the right-hand panel. Name your project something that keeps you organized. Then, set the aspect ratio to 16:9, change the frame rate to 60 FPS, and hit Save. Now bring in the magic. Drag in all the animated clips from your dialogue sequence. Got your own sound effects library? Awesome, add that too. If not, no stress, you've got options. CapCut's built-in sound effects. Custom voices or sounds via DupDub or 11 Labs, or search the YouTube audio library for free cinematic effects. Sound effects aren't optional, they're essential. They give your scene life, weight, and emotional impact. And in just a second, you'll hear exactly why. Now it's time to build your timeline. Add your animations in the exact order of your dialogue. You can drag them in manually or just click the blue plus button on each clip. Next, clean up your scene. Trim the silent gaps at the beginning and end of each animation. Move the playhead to the right spot, then use the shortcut Control plus B to slice. Repeat this for every clip until your dialogue flows like one seamless cinematic take. Now breathe life into your scene. Drop in your sound effects right where they belong. For example, buzzing neon lights, distant city ambience, soft thunder outside the window. If an effect is too short, just duplicate it to stretch it across the full section. Trim the end if needed. Pro tip, adjust volumes carefully. Sound effects should enhance your scene, not overpower it. And remember, dialogue is always king. It's the emotional spine of your entire sequence. Sound effects don't belong everywhere. They belong in the right moment. Think like a director. In my scene, when the line hits, and now someone is dead, I dropped in a powerful hit drone sound. Boom, the weight of the scene lands. And right there, I layered in a tension building effect. Drones tension movie. It adds a dark cinematic texture, pulling the viewer deeper into the story. To push the moment even further, I added a heartbeat effect under the dialogue. It raises the pressure, makes the audience feel the tension, not just hear it. And if an effect doesn't land cleanly, just slightly adjust its speed. Keep it subtle, keep it sharp. The key here is precision and feeling. Let the emotion drive your decisions. To amplify a big emotional beat, I used a simple but powerful function, zoom in. Here's how to do it. Place the playhead where the zoom should begin, set a keyframe, move to the end of the clip, slightly increase the scale. That small visual shift builds tension and syncs beautifully with the rising audio. At this point, I tested a second layer, a sound called epic tension. I timed its peak exactly with the word dead. The effect? So powerful. I actually removed the earlier hit drone. It wasn't needed anymore. Sometimes less is more. Let's do a quick test. First, watch your scene without any sound effects.
I told you, I don't know anything.
Then help me understand why your fingerprints are all over the crime scene.
What? That's not possible. I wasn't even there.
Funny. That's exactly what the last suspect said before they confessed.
You think I did it, don't you?
I think you know a lot more than you're telling me.
I was scared. I didn't know what to do.
You ran. And now someone's dead.
It wasn't supposed to happen like that.
You're not a very good liar, Evelyn.
Version 1 is dry, visual, and flat. Now play version 2, with full sound design layered in.
I told you, I don't know anything.
Then help me understand why your fingerprints are all over the crime scene.
What? That's not possible. I wasn't even there.
Funny. That's exactly what the last suspect said before they confessed.
You think I did it, don't you?
I think you know a lot more than you're telling me.
I was scared. I didn't know what to do.
You ran. And now someone's dead.
It wasn't supposed to happen like that.
You're not a very good liar, Evelyn.
Feel the difference? Sound doesn't just decorate a scene, it transforms it, from good to unforgettable. And just like that, you created a complete dialogue scene from scratch, all powered by a few smart tools and your own imagination. Let that sink in. We built cinema with AI. Now it's time. Hit the blue export button in the top right, and give yourself a moment, a quiet nod, a small applause. But wait, there's still one reward left. Seriously, if you're still watching, you're not just curious, you're committed. And that deserves something special. I'm showing an exclusive invite link to my AI Creator Discord server right now. But here's the twist. You won't find it in the description. This is just for those who actually show up. Inside the server, AI news, red hot niches to make money with AI, social media trends, tools, tips, and real results. But I've got one small ask before you go. Drop a comment below and tell me, what AI tutorial should I do next? I'll read every single one. Now go check the invite on screen, and I'll see you inside. This is the way. Peace out.